ARK Exploration is one of the biggest explorers in Indonesia. It's looking for gold and also copper. The chief executive is Jeff Malaihollo, and he joins us now. Jeff, welcome.
Hi.
Outline the investment case in ARK Exploration.
Look, ARK Exploration is a well-financed, active explorer. We've got assets in Indonesia and in Australia. Particularly in Indonesia, there's one that we're actively drilling at this stage, and we think the results will be transformational for the company. But in terms of assets, we are looking at high-grade epithermal gold that's at the surface, and also we're looking at large what's called porphyry copper deposit.
What about the joint ventures? Because you've got a partner, and you've got a big partner, haven't you?
That's correct, yes. We've got Anglo America as a partner in Indonesia. We've got two projects in Indonesia. One in Papua, Anglo America is managing that. We've got 20% carried interest all the way to decision to mine. And the other one, which we're managing at this stage, in Trenggalek, in East Java, Anglo America is earning into that. They're spending $10 million to get 51%. If they don't spend the $10 million, the project referred back to us. Subsequently, after that, they can go up to 75% by spending another $10 million. The project itself is jointly managed at this stage. We're managing in the ground, but we've got people from both Anglo-American and us doing it, and there's a joint venture committee running it.
What's the potential at Trenggalek?
Trenggalek's got huge potential. Firstly, back in 2010, 2011, ARK Exploration drilled that, and we found a lot of high-grade epithermal. We've tested, there's about 10-kilometer-long veins combined. We've tested about 5% of it, testing it down to about 150 meters, and we're getting up to 20 meters intersection running 4 or 5 gram material. So there's some really nice potential there. That's at the surface. What Anglo America is interested in doing now is drilling the porphyry copper potential that's at depth. Why do we think there's potential there? Because it's in the same arc with some of the largest deposits in Indonesia, Batu Hijau, Tujuh Bukit. Both are world-class targets. We've got the same geology, same age, rock, same structure. We've got a huge alteration footprint at the surface, meaning there's a lot of hot fluid coming through the system that you can see. We've also got a lot of gold, copper, and molybdenum footprint at the surface. Even some copper that we found at depth when we start drilling it. So all of that, plus geophysical signature, is very similar to some of these large reports that I mentioned before. So we feel there's a very good case of presence of copper deposit at depth.
Well, it's an interesting outlook for Indonesia, but you're also in Australia, aren't you, as you mentioned?
That's
why
correct.
Australia? What's so attractive there?
Part of it is portfolio diversification, so we don't put all our eggs in one country, so to speak. But also the projects in Australia are all long-term projects. The commitment there, we've got three projects. For each one of the projects, we've only got a $100,000 commitment to about July next year. And then after that, we have to spend $1.1 million for each of the project all the way to 2017, 2018. So they're long-term options as far as I'm concerned. Having said that, they're fantastic projects. Juni in particular, we've got some really nice grades. One that sticks in my mind is 22 meters at 37 gram ton gold, so over an ounce. So really nice high grade stuff. The other advantage of Australia is each one of those projects are in known gold deposit, area. They all got resources, and they all come with a large database of drill results and geophysics. So we're now in the process of reanalyzing all of that and see what's the next step.
Market cap about $6 million, haven't you? You've got $2 million of cash. You mentioned some of the money and where it's going to go and so forth. How long is that $2 million you've got at the moment going to last you? And how are you going to sustain the company after that?
Firstly, a bit of correction is $2.7 million.
$2.7 million, okay, in cash.
But also, look, our burn rate is probably running about $1 million to $1.5 million a year. So we should be okay for the next 18 to 24 months. In that time frame, we hope we can define the porphyry target in Trenggalek. We hope we can at least advance one of the Australian projects and hopefully increase the resource. So there's still a lot of news flow in the next 18 months or so.
So what are the milestones then? What should we watch out for?
The main one is, I think, the next 3 to 6 months. We are actively drilling in Trenggalek, and that's where I think it's transformational for a company. If we hit the porphyry copper deposit, then that's potentially will change the shape of the company. That's a huge milestone. And then the other milestones are the projects in Australia, in particular in understanding the distribution of the high-grade gold.
Yeah. Okay, Jeff, it's a pleasure. And thanks for joining us here at Money for Money.
Many thanks, Jeremy.
Okay, Jeff Malaihollo is the Chief Executive of ARC Exploration.